energy in this body, within us. Every one of us has a mind. Mind is the fastest energy in the world, according to the teaching of the Buddha. You know, mind, the Buddhism, is based on mind. It is because of mind that we are active, we are alive. So without mind, nobody can live. All beings have mind. So mind has to be understood. In comparison to other beings, according to Buddhist cosmology, there are 31 different realms. In all these realms, there are beings. They all have minds. In comparison to them, human's mind is a developed mind, which can be further developed. So as the Buddha has taught us clearly, this mind can be purified, mind can be developed. So we Buddhists try to understand this mind. The mind is to be understood through our own mind. That is the difficulty. The mind is the fastest energy in the world. It is the vital energy within us. Yes, there are different aspects of mind. According to the teaching of the Buddha, Buddha has very clearly said there are three different aspects for which the Buddha has used different terms even. Buddha used the terms Chitta, Mano and Vijnana. Chitta is our consciousness. Mano is mind. Vijnana, for Vijnana, of course, in our language, in English or in other language, we don't find a particular term for that. For instance, in English, we use both, for both consciousness, we use the two terms, consciousness and mind. So, Chitta, we use the term consciousness for Chitta, and consciousness for Vijnana. Therefore, it is difficult to understand these three aspects in this language. But the Buddha has clearly defined these three. Consciousness, the Chitta, when the mind is connected to our heart, it is called Chitta. That is the emotional aspect of our mind. When the mind is connected to our brain, it is called mind, Mano. Then when the mind is connected to our senses, we have six senses, six different senses. Eye, ear, the nose, tongue, body and mind. Mind itself is a sense. So mind is connected to these six senses. When the mind is connected to these six senses, it is called consciousness, it is called Vijnana. So these are the three aspects, Chitta, Mano and Vijnana. Mind, these are the three places, as I said. Mind has no particular one place to locate. Nobody can say this is where the mind is located. But mind is always associate with these three different locations, our heart, brain and senses. Those are the three places that it associates. Mind and nama has a difference. Mind depends on nama, nama rupa. You know, the Buddha has said this in discourses clearly. Nama rupa paccaya vijnana. Vijnana paccaya nama rupa. Nama rupa depends on vijnana. Vijnana depends on Nama Rupa. This means they are interdependently existing. Nama Rupa at one side, Vijnana is the other side. So Nama Rupa depends on Vijnana. So, whenever we use the term Nama, it is not Vijnana, it is not consciousness, it is not mind. It is part of mind, it is part and parcel of mind, though it is not the mind. Nama means feeling, perception, volitional formation, contact and attention. These five are called Nama. Then Pathavi, Apo, Tejo, Vayu, earth, water, fire, air. These four are called Rupa. So these two together complete in one side, that is Nama Rupa, and the other side is Vijnana, consciousness or mind. So that is how this sansaric cycle is formed. With this completion of the form, this completion of the sansaric cycle, beings are born again and again in sansara. One day everybody will have to cut off this sansaric cycle for the attainment of enlightenment. Meditation means focusing this mind. We can focus this mind to a particular object. That may be internal or external. The Buddha, according to the Buddha's technique of meditation, Buddha has said to focus this mind to different objects. When we focus our mind to a particular object, we give our attention as well. That is what is when we focus, we give our full attention. With that, we can understand, we can concentrate this mind. So mind is the fastest energy, as I said earlier. Energy produces when something is vibrating, when something is changing. So not some particular things, but everything. Everything is ever-changing. Everything is in a vibration. Once Einstein said, the whole world is nothing but a vibration. So everything is in the process of changing. Buddha said this 2600 years ago. Buddha said everything is impermanent. That is what is changing. Energy. So mind is energy. It is this energy, this mind is corrupt. It is corrupted. It is defiled with some adventitious defilement. In the Anguttara Nikaya, numerical discourses of the Buddha, Buddha said, luminous, O monks, is this mind, but with the adventitious defilement, this mind is defiled. So this defiled mind can be purified, can be developed. That is what is called, that development of mind or purification of mind is called meditation or bhavana. Mindfulness is not the mind, but it is the part of mind. Mindfulness means attention, awareness, earnestness. That is when we are aware of the present moment, when we are fully alert in the present moment, that is what is called mindfulness. Mindful does not mean that our mind is full with something. It is not, the mind is not full, but mind is alert. Alertness of mind is called mindfulness. It is through mindfulness, clear comprehension and wisdom that we can see through and we can completely extirpate, completely cut off all defilements and attain enlightenment. mind itself is impermanent. Everything is impermanent. Because mind is, as I said, mind is the fastest energy. It is the fastest, it's the rapidly, it is rapidly changing all the time. It is the fastest changing thing in the world. Therefore, mind is changing, mind is impermanent. Once the Buddha said to a person, he came and when asked, he said that this body and mind, referring to body and mind, he believed that mind is self. The Buddha said, it is better you grasp this body, this form as self, because this body remains quite unchanging, remain longer than mind. So mind is changing faster than body and everything. That is why we call mind is the fastest energy in the world. It is changing, it is impermanent.
Thank you. Mind.
Well, for the purification of mind, Buddha has very well designed a technique. That technique is called Satipatthana technique. Sati means mindfulness. Patthana means established. So that is the establishment of mindfulness. Where the Buddha delivered a particular discourse for this purpose. That is called Satipatthana Sutta. The establishment of mindfulness, discourse on establishment of mindfulness, where in the preamble, in the very first statement, Buddha said, this is the only way for the purification of mind, for the purification of mind. This is the only way. This is the only way for the purification of mind, for the overcoming of sorrow and lamentation, for the disappearance of pain and grief, for the reaching of the path, for the attainment of enlightenment. This is the only way. What is that? The four establishments of mindfulness. So this is the way. This is the way for the purification of mindfulness. Four establishments of mindfulness. Where the Buddha said, establish your mindfulness on your body. Then said, establish your mind on your feelings. Then said, establish your mind on your mind. Then finally said, as the fourth factor said, establish your mind on mental objects. These are called four satipatthana, or four establishments of mindfulness. That is how one has to purify this mind. Well, we cannot say who, because there is no persons to attain Nibbana. This mind, when the mind is purified, when the mind is developed, when the mind is cultivated, developed, cultivated, purified, mind attains Nibbana. Mind attains liberated. This is very clearly said in the discourses, not only Buddha, even other. Enlightened ones, they express their bliss, their attainment at the liberation. They said in Pali, they say, Kina Jati, they themselves can realize their attainment, their enlightenment. Then they express, Kina Jati, the birth is destroyed. Usitang brahmacharyam, I lived the holy life. Katang karaniyam, done what had to be done. Naparang ittattayati pajanati. Then there is no more, nothing more to be done is realized. So liberation, when they realize this liberation, when mind is liberated, they say, it is liberated. When it is liberated, they say, it is liberated, not I am liberated, or not he is liberated, she is liberated, but it is liberated. Vimuktasmin vimuktam iti jnanam hoti. Vimuktasmin vimuktam iti jnanam hoti means when it is liberated, they know that it is liberated. What is liberated? Mind is liberated. So our mind is liberated. Not a person, I, you, me, not such, but mind. Our mind is liberated because it is released from all defilements. As we remove all defilements, mind becomes luminous. It is a luminous mind, luminous all over. That is why it is called Anantang Sabbato Pabang. Anantang, infinite this mind, and Anantang, infinite. Sabbato Pabang, all over, luminous all over. That is the liberated mind. So friends, this mind is liberated. That is how we have to understand mind. And that's all practice. That's all meditate. When we meditate, we all can understand this mind. We all can understand our own nature. And finally, we all can understand, realize real peace, real happiness of Nibbana.